Can I ask you, which came first, the chapters or the art, or was it simultaneous, you know?
You mean the art that's like, so there are didactics at the beginning of each part, right, that show the art. Those came in revision. So originally the art had always been integral to the story. It had been folded through the narrative. And my editor, Miriam, and I spoke about the idea of taking that art and creating almost like a museum didactic.
Yes.
How would you summarize the art to an outside observer?
Yes. And so I love those because I felt like each one was kind of this beautiful way into you know, there's some modern art exhibits, right, where you see where the art is not static, right, where it's a video piece, but you have like the context presented on the placard, and it very much felt like moving through rooms in a museum, in a gallery. And so to come back to something that you mentioned before, right, where you said the flashbacks were going to be short, and each, and in fact, that was one of the really vivid things about it, the way the story moves through time, mm-hmm. and in many cases gives us a relatively short window that feels like a window, that feels like a frame in a way, where you're seeing the captured moment. Talk about that.
Talk about it, explain it. Well, I also just wanted to say on the art didactics, I love that you picked up on this idea of moving through a museum, because the pieces that begin each part of the book are absolutely thematically tied to the part that follows them, right? So there's a part of the book dedicated to Henry, the human character, and it begins with a piece of art that his sister did when she was in school, that is a metal heart hanging from the ceiling, and you're invited to pour different liquids of different viscosities into it, and it's full of holes, and watch it come back out again. And like, so each art piece is tied in that way. But yeah, so the interesting thing about Addie's narrative is a story told across 300 years and a story told across a single year. And one of the greatest structural difficulties was finding a way to fuse these two time periods and have them be in balance. Because this is a story about Addie's relationship with the devil from 1714 to 2014. And it's a story about her encountering Henry, a human young man in New York, in 2014. And so it had to be about, I don't know about you, I love structural fusion. I loved it in Vicious, where it became a matter of braiding three narratives. Like, I love the challenge of structural work. And so this really became a puzzle piece of how do we fuse, how do we bend the world around this character in such a way that every time we spend time with her in the past, we're not only moving her storyline forward, we're not only understanding her relationship with Luke more, but we're bringing her more into line with the present intersections. So each past scene also needs to tie into what she's going through in the present, because the thing about Addie is that she's living in an eternal present. She has a flawless memory, which means everything she's ever experienced is crystalline. And so I needed the past to feel as vivid as the present. But at the same time, I didn't want this book to become a travelogue. It would be very easy for this book to be 1,000 pages long and for her to just dawdle her way through history. So it became really difficult to pick every single moment with intention that we were going to visit along her timeline. And I think we ended up with, I'm not gonna say the number because I'd just be making it up off the top of my head, but it's like less than 20, right? They needed to be kind of thin interstitial moments throughout history.